This is a nature boutique hotel in the middle of a national park in winter in Finland. And this is how they grow their own fresh ingredients in-house using vertical farming. Let's talk about it. What's up, guys, and welcome back to the channel. It's Oliver here, and welcome to the beautiful Nuuksio National Park here in the southern parts of Finland. And more specifically, welcome to the Haltia Lake Lodge, a small but really cool nature boutique hotel that offers unique hotel and glamping experiences here in the middle of the Finnish wilderness. So if you don't know, glamping is an abbreviation of glamorous camping, and in this case it means living in one of these really cool luxury glamping tents. So these are basically heated tents with all the amenities that one would expect to find in a really nice hotel room. Anyways, Haltia Lake Lodge was chosen as the best sustainable hotel by the Boutique Hotel Awards 2022, and everything that they do is focused on making the hospitality industry more environmentally sustainable. So this starts all the way from how their glamping lodges are constructed, all the way to how they source their furniture to the hotel. The latest solution that they're trying is to use indoor vertical farming to grow their own fresh ingredients inside the hotel premises using these modules. So if you don't know, vertical farming is a rapidly growing food production method where instead of growing plants on a single plane of production, the plants are grown vertically upwards to maximize production per square unit of land used. As we have explained in previous videos like the one right here, vertical farming can be done using many different form factors, but the two most common ones are the horizontally stacked layers and the vertically inverted growing surfaces, just like what you can see right here. Again, while there are many methods for growing plants vertically, most vertical farms use something called hydroponics. Again, there are many types of hydroponic systems, but to simplify, hydroponics is a soilless growing method that uses a nutrient-rich water solution that is fed directly into the plant root zones and which is then circulated back into the system to be reused. So instead of getting their nutrient from the soil, the plants get everything they need from the nutrient solution itself. Also, while vertical farms can use natural sunlight to grow the plants, just like what is done in greenhouses, most vertical systems use specially manufactured LEDs to supply the plants with the right amount and type of light for maximum growth. So all of this also applies to the systems right behind me over there. So these vertical farming modules used by Haltia Lake Lodge are specifically designed for the hospitality and retail industries, and they enable any hotel, restaurant, cafeteria, or for example supermarket to grow their own fresh herbs, leafy greens, and berries inside their own premises, regardless of the location and the time of year. So the way that these farming modules work is actually pretty simple. At the bottom, we have a tank of water, and in the tank, we have a nutrient-rich water mixture that is pumped up the wall and sprayed at high pressure directly into the plant's roots. This kind of a mist-based method is also called aeroponics. Once sprayed into the roots, the water falls back into the water tank and circulates back into the system. In addition to the irrigation system, we use a single pair of growing LEDs that are oriented vertically. In fact, one of the benefits of this type of a system compared to stacked systems is that since all of the plants grow on a single plane of production, we only need one pair of LEDs to light the entire system. Compare this to stacked systems, which need one or two LEDs per level. This system is also stacked with sensors and other technology that measures and optimizes the growing environment inside the unit, depending on the crops being grown at each moment in time. All right, so why should a hotel grow their own ingredients using vertical farming? What are some of the pros and cons of this type of a system? If we start with the pros, as you can see, these units are really tiny in their footprint. In fact, this system particularly takes less than 1 square meter in space. That's less than 10 square feet. So unlike most stacked systems, which take significantly more space, these can actually be very easily fitted into any indoor space without taking room from customer seating. Naturally, being fully optimized for each plant, the product quality is incredible. And because the produce is literally being grown in the dining hall and harvested right before serving, it can't really get more fresh than this. This means that the taste and feel of the product is pretty much out of this world, and this technology creates a completely new sensory experience for the hotel customers. Because we grow the produce in the customer's premises, literally just a few meters from the bar, and the kitchen, there is no packaging materials or waste created in the process. And of course, we don't have to ship the produce hundreds and hundreds of kilometers from a farm to a logistics center and finally to a customer using large trucks. This is of course great, especially with a location like Haltia Lake Lodge, which is literally located in the middle of a national park. All of these are great benefits, but of course, since these systems are meant to be used inside hotels and restaurants, it's also super important that the presentation looks, well, cool. After all, it's just a part of the hotel experience, and using these kind of vertical inverted growing surfaces where the plants grow sideways, we put the plants in the center of attention with an otherwise pretty minimalistic look. All right, so these are the pros from the customer's perspective. However, this type of a system does also have a couple of other benefits, specifically when compared to other stacked vertical systems. First, and as I already mentioned earlier, most stacked systems are inherently larger in their footprint compared to what we have right here. So this is due to their general design philosophy, and it's actually a big no-no for most hotels and restaurants, which are already pretty cramped and short in space. Especially since most vertical farming systems are still nice to haves and not really mandatory tools for the hospitality industry, they simply cannot take space from customer seating. So another good thing about this specific design compared to stacked systems is the ease of use. So it's a good rule of thumb that with stacked systems, you can usually go only 1, 2, 3, 4 levels up before you no longer can actually see or reach the plants that you're working with. Also, working with the lowest layers is usually not really good for ergonomics. So either you have to step on a ladder to reach the top plants or crouch down to the lowest plants. This makes working with the system pretty difficult and also time consuming, and it creates an artificial barrier for the hotel or restaurant staff to actually use the system on a daily basis. Again, this is a big no-no in the hospitality industry where the work of the staff is already difficult as is, and we really do not want to make it more difficult because of our design choices. So on the other hand, with this kind of a vertically inverted design, we can actually see and reach all of the plants from floor level, and this makes the daily maintenance, inspection, and even harvesting extremely easy and comfortable. All right, so those are some of the pros of this kind of an inverted vertical farming design. So what are some of the cons? Well, the first and the most obvious is, of course, that a system this size simply cannot grow all the produce that a hotel, restaurant, and especially a retail store would use. Instead, these systems are great for growing high-cost, low-volume products that are normally imported into the country with low quality. This could mean any expensive herbs or specialty crops like, for example, edible flowers. And of course, in a country like Finland, where we have a long and dark winter, and where a significant part of the fresh greens are imported from abroad, the quality and price of produce from wholesale has a tendency of fluctuating heavily around the year. This means that we can actually use these kind of systems to grow a range of products during the winter while still making financial sense. On the other hand, during the summer, we can focus on more specialized crops like Mitsuna, which we have growing right behind me. So growing these types of specialty products, of course, means that the customer can get the best return for their investment. Talking about the crops, the second big con of this kind of a system, as is with any other vertical farm, is the limited amount of produce that can be grown in them. This is not only limited by the physical dimensions of these kind of systems, but also, of course, by economics. So you could easily grow a large assortment of berries and even some more protein-dense products in this kind of a system, which we have actually done already. But the problem is that the plants need to be either pollinated by hand, if we want them to produce fruit, or in the case of, for example, soybeans, the production per square unit of land used isn't still that much, so it doesn't really make any economic sense. Also, pollinating by hand, it's a lot of work compared to the output, and again, often not worth it. So the third con is obviously the price. So yes, customers will pay a premium price for the produce compared to a standard wholesale price per kilo. Having said this, the customer of course does get more than just the utility of the fresh produce. Basically, using vertical farming inside their own premises is a part of the brand, the storytelling, and the overall customer experience. And of course, while this does not magically make the hospitality industry sustainable, it's a step in the right direction as it allows the users to decouple at least a part of their ingredient procurement from the traditional food production system. So talking of which, if you want to learn more about the sustainability of vertical farming, make sure to check out this video for a more detailed breakdown. Bye.